It just gives the impression that among other people I've talked with that the school board is trying to be less than transparent when they don't really make a big issue about when the meetings are. And I don't know if it's the newspaper that's also not publishing them in a timely manner, but many times I open up a newspaper a day or two later and I say, there was a board meeting or there was a work session or whatever. So I think it's very hard for people who do not have kids in school to actually force themselves to go online and find out when the meetings are.
So I believe Wisconsin statute still requires publication in the paper.
Right, I know they publish.
Not online, that's that part of it. And so, Nancy can address this better than I, but they're on the website as soon as they, like I said, I can tell you every board meeting between now and June 30th. They're online, they're a full year in advance. The agendas that are published and we try to put some links to it and I think we have even, and I'm not 100% certain because I don't look at them all the time, even one of the recommendations from Judy was to have a link that goes from here to here and I believe that that has happened so that you can click onto it easier than you did before. And so that the agenda part of it, but the board meetings themselves are very well in advance published.
When my son was in school and we were getting the newsletters online, the actual high school newsletters would be online. I tended to see the Facebook posting sometimes and I didn't necessarily want to have it on my own Facebook, scroll because there were so many things that were not of interest in mine, especially like the athletics and the sports. And they seem to be constantly posting things, the athletics. Anyway, are the school board meetings ever posted on Facebook? Because that is something that more people probably would have access to.
We do a meeting recap of it.
But not beforehand?
No.
See, that's, I think a lot of people are missing out on getting more involvement because I think a lot of people do Facebook now. And if you're doing it afterwards, just like I said, I open up the newspaper app and I see, oh, there was a meeting, you know, I missed the announcement.
Well, like I said, the agenda is one thing, but the notification of meetings, you know, that's their early and often. And so that, so on our newsletter, on our whatever, those things are there. And like I said, they'll set in July the agenda, or in June the agenda for the entire school year. And it's very seldom, we might add an extra one. I think we've only changed the date once in my this year. And that was by a week, and we did it 3 months in advance to make sure that that one was out there.
I just think in this day and age, most people are just seeing on their devices, whether it's Facebook, you know, Twitter, or whatever.
Yeah.
They're not necessarily going to go out as much, especially if you don't have a kid in the school system. You're still a taxpayer. For you to go out and go to the website and look for it, and then have to maybe put it on a calendar or transpose the meetings, whatever, I just think you're missing some involvement of people in the community by now.
It seems like that
more upfront
the web page, the posting in that direction would have just as much as Facebook. If you're a Facebooker, you're also a technology person and would go that route. And so I'm the other way around. I'm the other way around. I'm not. So if I'm going to go, I'm going to go to somebody's webpage, I'm going to go to somebody else's. I'm not going to go to Facebook because it's so inaccurate so often.
But see,
so
web pages are also not updated accurately, and I'm not saying that's with the school district because you do have a paid person who's probably updating your website. But a lot of websites I go to learn about organizations, nonprofits especially, the web pages are a year old or whatever, they haven't updated. I know a lot of older folks, older than me, they have grandchildren, whatever, they are on Facebook all the time. Forget about going on a web page, but if it's on Facebook,
and at some point in time, maybe the Wisconsin legislature will change the law. At
this
point,
could you do something other than just follow the law? I mean, if you could put it on Facebook.
We put it, it's in multiple places that you can go online, and so, like I said, yeah, so it's online, and so Facebook is online, just like,
But Nancy just said it's only, the school board is mentioned, the meetings are mentioned after the fact.
Well, you know, the meetings are mentioned well in advance, okay?
Online.
Online.
On the webpage.
On the webpage.
Okay, I'm not gonna win this, obviously.
No, but they're certainly mentioned. The agenda isn't necessarily 6 months in advance.
But
there's not any secrets as to when the board meetings are.
But I'm just saying, if you wanted more people to attend, and a wider variety of people to attend, not just the folks who maybe have a bone to pick, or people who are employed by the school district, because it's obvious that.
And we're not gonna agree on this one.
Right.
I think there's multiple avenues for that to happen, and does happen. And we truly, we don't even have to do this, but we know that this makes sense, because that's technology is the way we go. And so that we do that, and like I said, Facebook, some do, some don't. And so with that, because of the ability to so we have a Facebook page, and we do things, and we do newsletters, and we do
calendars. Newsletters, a lot of them just
unseen by the people. Well, because that's who they chooses to see them, okay? But they're available, okay?
I know.
And so that, yeah.
But in order to get people involved in like this referendum, or to even see what's going on in other matters that they might have an opinion on, you know, we talk to a lot of people in the community at our church, and they don't know what the heck is going on with the school district. And I think in a way, you're probably happy that you're not getting more people to invest in.
We absolutely never discourage participation.
Then how come it's the same people? You just mentioned in an article newspaper that it's only people who have like an axe to grind that show up at the school board meetings.
And so many times, I just, not just Western Massachusetts, the reality is that oftentimes the people who are the most vocal are the ones who have the biggest axe or concern, okay? That when you do a survey, when you do whatever, the ones who typically have strong opinions are the ones who are going to participate the most. Sometimes silence is a admission of everything is okay. And so that I'm not saying that, but I just, the reality is that if you have an axe to grind, if you are, Carol is upset with something, you're going to find it, okay? You're not going to just sit past it. If you don't have any question, you don't have a concern, you're probably not going to get as involved with it as you might. And so we're going to probably agree to disagree on this one. I truly believe that we do a good job of promoting the website as much as we can. What I'd like to do is to focus it back now to the referendum. And so if you have referendum questions,